Hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar, and today we are going to talk about who should stop eating gluten and when. So I have been talking about what gluten is and what sort of diseases people might have where gluten can be issue causing, but for the rest of the audience it is not a problem. For about 1 out of 100 or a little bit more than 1 out of 100, it is a problem. So gluten, the problems with gluten are celiac disease, wheat sensitivity, wheat allergy, and some more. So the symptoms in gluten related diseases are something like abdominal pain, bloating, fatigue, diarrhea. Sometimes gluten sensitivity, people might experience headache, muscle and joint pain, and there are many more symptoms. So how would you know if you need to stop eating gluten and when? So first of all, this video is for those who have any sort of problem. If you do not have any sort of problem in your body, then you do not need to watch this video. You can watch the video for your knowledge, but you do not need to watch it for yourself specifically. So first of all, you should have symptoms similar to those of gluten intolerance symptoms, and it is also likely that you might have observed this by now. If you have gluten related disease, that when you eat gluten rich products, then your issues, your body issues come up. So gluten is present in wheat, barley and rye majorly. Wheat and barley are Indian grown products. Rye is mostly grown in foreign countries. I mentioned this so that you know the name. And rye is not the small black colored ball that your mother is using in home. Rye is a crop just like barley or wheat. Similar to barley or wheat, mostly grown in countries outside India. Okay, now how to go about knowing that if you have any gluten problem and you should stop eating gluten? So first, we should go for checkup of celiac disease, if we have celiac disease or not. Testing for celiac disease. The test name is TTGIGA. You can go for the check. If it is a positive, if you have a celiac disease, then you should stop eating gluten and do as your doctor prescribes. If the test is negative, if you do not have celiac disease, then and still you are facing issues in your body, if you have symptoms in your body similar to those of gluten related diseases, then maybe those symptoms are just because you have an improper diet, you are not taking the right diet. So first, try to improve your diet and see if the symptoms go away. So improve your diet, remove the junk food out of your diet and add healthy food to your diet. Just eat clean, just eat healthy by including more fruits and vegetables, more whole grains, beans, lentils. Eat healthy, no junk food, do it for a couple of weeks and see if your symptoms improve. If your symptoms improve, then most probably it was because of your improper diet that you were having those symptoms. So just stick to a healthy diet and your symptoms should completely go away. If there is no improvement by improving the diet, by changing the diet towards a healthy diet, then you still have the symptoms, then see, it can be because of gluten, but there can be a lot of other reasons because of which you can have these symptoms. So these are like normal symptoms. Abdominal pain can be because of improper digestion, excess growth of bacteria in your gut. Fatigue can be because of improper eating habits or eating a lot of junk food. Same can be with bloating and diarrhea. So these are general symptoms. So you first need to see if these symptoms are arising because of some other sort of disorders. For example, lactose intolerance. Some people drink milk and they are not able to digest the sugar in milk, which is lactose, and they feel bloated and they feel abdominal pain, etc. So first see if there are disorders like lactose intolerance. Some people are fructose intolerant. Fructose is a sugar like glucose. So if you cannot digest fructose, then you might face problems. You see if you have any other intestinal disorders, if your digestive system is working fine, if you have overgrowth of bacteria in your gut or overgrowth of bad bacteria in your gut. So there can be a lot of other reasons for your symptoms. See, go to multiple doctors maybe, and thoroughly get yourself checked. Ask them to basically eliminate all the cases that can be possible for these sort of symptoms. If you find that you have some disorder which is not related to gluten, then take the treatment for that disorder. If by getting checked by all the doctors that you visit and doing all you could, you still could not find any disorder that you have, any problem or disease that you have, you could not find anything, then maybe you want to try removing gluten from your diet. Now, once you remove gluten from your diet, see if it improves your symptoms, if it gets you rid of the problems that you were facing. If it doesn't get you rid of the problems that you were facing, then basically the symptoms were not because of gluten. So again, start eating gluten, because if without any reason, if you stop eating gluten, then it can create you problems. Then you can be gluten sensitive in future. And if stopping gluten helped you, if your symptoms improved, if your health improved, then you can stick with the gluten-free diet, and you also might want to periodically challenge yourself with gluten. So after a few weeks, maybe like 4 weeks, you want to again eat gluten. After 4 weeks of gluten-free diet, might want to again eat gluten, because doing so periodically might help your body get accustomed to digesting gluten. So maybe in future you become able to digest gluten, or maybe you become able to remove the problems that you were having because of gluten. Now, so you should take this way to know. Now, the people who have celiac disease or who were gluten sensitive and found that their symptoms improved, their health improved when they stopped taking gluten. The people who stopped taking gluten should take care of this. That in the market you will find a lot of things that say gluten-free, no gluten. First of all, these things cost a lot, sometimes as much as 3 times plus than the cost of the same food. For example, gluten-free flour is around 120 rupees, and the normal wheat flour is around 24 or 25 rupees per kilogram. So basically, when you see gluten-free products in the market, you think that they are gluten-free, but they might be contaminated with some gluten. See, a person facing problems with gluten can have issues in the body even with small amounts of gluten. So what happens is, in the factories there are a lot of things that get made together. So if there is anything which is said to be gluten-free and it comes in contact with something which has gluten, let's say wheat flour, then even a small trace of wheat flour with the thing that is packaged as gluten-free can create problem to the person who has gluten issues. So it is better that you cook in your own kitchen. So I know a person whose children were not growing, they were in fact shrinking. He met me on a medical shop and he was buying 120 rupees per kilogram flour. So I asked him, why this flour, why not normal flour? So he told me that he's buying it for his children. His children were shrinking, not growing. So he went to doctor. Doctor asked for a test and they came out to be celiac patient. So that is why he was buying that flour. And then he told me that so in their kitchen there is a separate space where they do not touch any other thing. That separate space is to cook for their children. So in that separate space they will cook the foods that do not get in touch with gluten or gluten related foods. gluten related products. So gluten containing products. So basically you want to keep a separate space for yourself in kitchen in case you stop gluten. Then the other options except wheat, barley and rye are bajra, sorghum, which is known as jawar in Hindi, corn or maize, rice. People eat corn flour, bajra flour, sorghum flour, rice flour. Okay, so these are options. And first, so the one who does not need to stop gluten should definitely not stop eating gluten, because if that person stops eating gluten, then that person might catch one of these gluten related diseases. That is the first thing. Secondly, it is a genetic disease. So if you catch the disease because you without any reason stopped eating gluten, then your children or your grandchildren might also have the disease, and when they start eating gluten, they can face problems. And gluten is good for your gut health. If you stop eating gluten, your gut health can degrade. Okay, so basically what you can understand by this is, if you stop eating chapati, the wheat chapati, then, and you do that for years, then you might stop being able to digest wheat chapati when you start eating it after a long time. Our ancestors in India ate it for ages. Our ancestors have been eating it for hundreds of years or maybe thousands of years, and our ancestors have lived individually for more than 100 years eating gluten rich foods. So this proves that gluten is not an unhealthy thing. So we can eat it unless we have any sort of gluten related issue. As our ancestors have been eating gluten for long periods of time, we are less likely to get diagnosed with any sort of gluten intolerance. And if we stop eating gluten, then our descendants, our children or grandchildren might face gluten related issues, because we genetically induce the disease. If gluten is healthy for most of the people, then why is there so much misinformation spread out there related to gluten, and why are people buying so gluten related foods? Why is gluten free considered healthy when gluten is healthy for most of the people? I'll talk about this in detail in my next video. I would recommend that you watch it. If you like this video, please like, comment and share. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.